more tears and maybe a little closure at a Baltimore County middle school where students remember two former classmates and their parents. It was a tragedy that rocked northern Baltimore County. Four members of the Browning family murdered in their Cockeysville home, allegedly by the couple's teenage son. But friends and classmates of the victims have found a way to help keep their memories alive. 11 News education reporter Tim Tootin is live in the Update Center with that story. Tim.
Well, Donna, students and staff members at Cockeysville Middle School are still trying to make sense out of what happened to the members of the Browning family. Today, they dedicated a memorial garden to the family, just one small gesture to try and help to ease the pain.
Each of you will grieve in your own way.
An entire school became one family in mourning outside Cockeysville Middle.
Ben, he came to school one August day, full of energy, spunk, and play. He liked his science in period one, gaining knowledge while having fun. With hair that loved the Van de Graaff, with comments that would make you laugh.
They tried to replace tears with memories.
Well, they're just such great people and such a great family. You know, it's hard not to think of all the good things that happened with them. And they did just contributed so much to the school and community.
We lost some quality individuals, but those of us who remain have a responsibility to ourselves and to our friends to never forget all that is good.
When you think of the tragedy, you just have to think of the bright side of things.
And the bright side for these students, a garden, fresh flowers, new life, and a plaque to remember.
Magnolia altiflora, in loving memory of CMS students Greg and Ben Browning and their parents Tammy and John Browning, taken from us February 2008. Gone but not forgotten. At this time, I formally dedicate this memorial garden in their memory.
This is your garden to sit, to reflect, to laugh, and to remember, and also create your own dreams and carry with you some of the words and thoughts you hear today.
The tragedy was so great, like, you know, so large, and it was hard for everyone to take it in. So I feel when seeing the beauty of this garden, you know, they'll think of the good memories and how great the family was.
Community and student volunteers have spent the past few weekends building the Browning Memorial Garden. Live in the studio, Tim Tootin, WBAL-TV.